Okay, in this video, I just want to show you guys two very cool limit questions. The first one is the limit as x approaches infinity. And you can see that the function, it's actually the same for both of them. We have e to the 1 over x minus e to the 1 over x squared. All right, and for the second one, we have the limit as x approaching 0 plus. So for this video, I would like you guys to pause the video now and then try the questions first before you watch the solution. Ready? Good. In fact, for the first one, we actually get to draw a conclusion along the way, and let me show you. So first, let's just put infinity into all the x's. We get e to the 1 over infinity, and then minus e to the 1 over, and here we have infinity squared. All right, let's draw arrow because this is about limit. And then here we have e to the 1 over infinity. And we see the 1 over infinity, that will give us 0. So for the first one, we just have e to the 0th power. And then we have to minus e. And now what do we have? This is infinity squared, which is still infinity. 1 over infinity, we also get 0. All right. And now e to the 0 is just 1. And then minus another e to the 0, which is 1. And this right here is what? 1 minus 1. So of course, we know the answer is going to give us 0. So for the first one, it's really straightforward because we get to draw a conclusion a long way. The final answer is just 0. But now if you take a look at the second one, if we put 0 plus into all the x's, then we'll first get e to the 1 over 0 plus. Then minus e to the 1 over, we have 0 plus squared. All right, 1 over 0 plus is what? This right here will give us positive infinity. So for the first one, we are going to get e to the infinity's power, and then minus base against e. But for this right here, 0 plus squared is still 0 plus, and then 1 over 0 plus, that's infinity. So for the power here, we also have infinity. Then e is bigger than 1, so e to the infinity's power, guess what? We have infinity, and then minus another e to the infinity, which is infinity. Uh-oh, what shall we do? This is infinity minus infinity. Can we just say the answer is equal to 0? No, right? This is an indeterminate form. This is an indeterminate form. We cannot do this, all right? So too bad, and we also don't get to say indeterminate and then box the answer. We really have to do more work in order to figure out what the answer is. So this is how I would approach it. Right? So this right here is going to be the following. My idea is when we have infinity minus infinity, we are just going to change the form. Sometimes we can actually change this to, let's say, 0 times infinity or anything else. Let me show you. So I will still have the limit as x approaching 0 plus. But if you look at the original, what I will do is, let me factor out the e to the 1 over x power. So I will have this right here first, and then we will have 1 first, and then minus. Now the question for you guys is, if we have e to the 1 over x power, and then we factored this out, what should we get? The answer is, just go ahead and write down e to the 1 over x squared as well. But the power here, you are going to minus 1 over x. Because technically, what we are doing is this divided by that. And when we divide, they have the same base. We subtract the powers. That's why it's 1 over x squared minus 1 over x. Another way to look at it is go ahead and distribute this. And when we do this times that, the bases are the same. So we add the powers, the 1 over x plus the minus 1 over x, they cancel out to be 0. Now, what good does this do? If we have 0 plus into the x, for the first one, we will get infinity. But how about for the second one, do we get anything weird? Well, we'll see. We have 1 minus, and then let's look at this part. This is still going to give us trouble. If you just put if you just put 0 plus, you will get infinity minus infinity, all right? But let's do the same thing. If you look at this, let's just factor out 1 over x. Actually, that's fact. Yeah, let's just factor out 1 over x. We will get 1 over x times 1 over x minus 1. Now, if x is approaching 0 plus, this term will give us infinity. And then this term will also give us infinity, then minus 1. Aha! Can we draw a conclusion for this? Yes, because we will first have infinity times infinity minus 1 is infinity. Infinity times infinity is infinity. Oh my god. So, in fact, this right here will give us e for the base and then infinity for the power. Let me actually write this down in blue. Because all this right here is just the exponent for the e, right? So it's e to the infinity. And now, if you look at this part, what we are going to get is just infinity times 1 minus, of course, this is infinity. And what's 1 minus infinity? It's negative infinity, all right? So this becomes infinity times negative infinity. And then what's infinity times negative infinity? In fact, the answer for this right here is just negative infinity. Do not write it as negative infinity squared. This is just infinity, all right? So as you can see, in fact, we changed from an infinity minus infinity situation to an infinity times negative infinity situation. And once we are here, we get to draw a conclusion. The answer is just negative infinity. So that's it. Negative infinity, and then we are done.